Zero harm is about eliminating risk from the business. And in the fleet world, for me, that's about multiple different avenues to get there. So we've got sort of vehicle maintenance, regular scheduled vehicle maintenance, and additional specification, such as fall protection on the back of vehicles, sensors, cameras, to aid the driver and also protect the driver when they're working on and around the vehicle. But then we've also got driver training, driver competencies, and driver education, and also monitoring their behaviours as well. So our permit to drive, it's our Balfabiti driving licence, it's our competency card for drivers. So that includes all drivers are in scope of that, whether you're grey fleet, a car driver, company car driver, van fleet or heavy goods vehicle driver, all drivers are in scope. So it includes a desktop risk assessment of the driver where it's looking at conviction history, if any, collision history, if any, as well as experience, additional qualifications, and all that forms a risk profile of our drivers, as well as doing online driver license checks through DVLA. And once they've passed all those elements, they will be issued with a permit to drive. Commercial vehicle drivers particularly, they all go through our in-house company e-learning program that we've developed. So that way, once they've got the permit to drive, they've got the competencies and we've told them what we expect of them as commercial vehicle drivers.
Yeah, so at Balfabiti, we're really proud of the sustainability journey we're on with regards transitioning all our vehicle types to alternative fuels across our car, LCV and HGV fleet. At the minute, our car fleet is currently 88% alternative fuel, with aspirations to get to 100% by the end of 2024. Our company car list is currently circa 50% EV, with the rest being plug-in hybrid and hybrid options to all our customers. On the LCV fleet, by the end of next year, we'll be circa 10% of the fleet will be electrified, with aspirations to get to 100% EV by the end of 2030. Moving into the HGV space, again a bit more challenging. We're looking at both EV and hydrogen options there, offering to our customer options on both. We're currently undergoing a project where we're trialling dual fuel technology on our HGVs with regards to hydrogen on both High Speed 2 and a local contract on the M77. So with regards to LCVs, that's a real challenge, but we've got a clear strategy that we're working on over the next 12 months to deliver the end-to-end charging infrastructure from at home, in the office and out on site, working with our colleagues in our plant team. It's even more difficult though in the HGV space. Again, we're unsure which way that's going to go, whether it's going to be EV or hydrogen, which is why we're currently doing the trials with our customers to understand the way forward there.